Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's clarify the idea of mass in mass spectrometry and introduce how different isotopes affect the interpretation of a mass spectrum. Molecules and fragments in mass spectrometry are observed based on their MZ values. Z, the charge, is generally plus 1, and M is the mass of the ion. Technically, mass is the sum of the atomic masses of every atom in the ion. Often the observed MZ is reported as a number rounded to its nearest integral value. Let's look at water. Water has a molecular weight, a molecular mass, of 18.015 grams per mole. That number reflects a statistical average of all the isotopes of hydrogen and oxygen. Mass spec does not detect a statistical average. It detects individual molecules with specific isotopes of hydrogen and oxygen. By far, most of the individual water molecules consist of one oxygen 16 atom and two hydrogen 1 isotopes. The mass of these molecules would be 18.011 Daltons. How would the parent ion of such a molecule appear in the mass spectrum? It would have an MZ of 18. Note this total mass as the sum of each of the most common isotopes is called the nominal mass. Note that for small molecules with atoms like hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen, which have 99% abundance of one major isotope, the nominal mass is the same as the molecular weight rounded to the nearest integral value. Glucose has a molecular mass of 180.156 grams per mole. Its nominal mass is 180. Nicotine has a molecular mass of 162.236 grams per mole. Its nominal mass is 162. Great, so for most small organics, we can expect to see the MZ value of a parent ion at the integral value of a molecule's molecular mass. Other isotopes and MZ values may be present and even somewhat visible, but the peak at the nominal mass strongly dominates. There are two common atoms that break this trend, chlorine and bromine. A key issue with chlorine is that it has two relatively abundant isotopes, chlorine-35 at 76% abundance and chlorine-37 at 24% abundance. For HCl, the most abundant isotope combination would be hydrogen 1, chlorine-35, with a mass of 36 Daltons. This would be the nominal mass of the parent ion. But wait, hydrogen 1, chlorine-37 would also be pretty big. That MZ value would be 38 Daltons. Those two peaks would have a ratio of roughly 75 to 25. Okay, the MZ36 peak is the nominal mass for the parent ion. This peak would be M, the parent ion peak. How would we refer to the additional large peak at 38? It is called the M+2 peak because it has a mass that is two larger than the parent ion, M. This pattern of having a 3-to-1 ratio in the peaks that are separated by two mass units is a sign that the ion contains a chlorine atom. This pattern is very useful in mass spectrometry. Bromine also has a similar pattern. Bromine has two isotopes, bromine-79 and bromine-81, with almost equal abundance, though bromine-79 is slightly more abundant. In HBr, the nominal mass of the parent ion is 80, but the signal at M+2 is almost the same intensity. This 1-to-1 ratio of these two peaks separated by two mass units is a sign of a bromine in a molecule. We have now introduced the idea of nominal mass for the most abundant isotopic composition of the peak and highlighted the characteristic M to M plus 2 pattern we see with chlorine and bromine-containing molecules. Thanks for watching. Take care.